لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله لا
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear students, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Today we are going to start the lecture of mathematics from the book of New Syllabus Mathematics, Oxford University Press. And sometimes this is called D1 Mathematics. Today our lecture is about the set of prime numbers and the set of composite numbers. So before understanding these concepts, that is what are prime numbers and what are composite numbers, we will have to understand the concept of factors. What is meant by a factor, a divisor, a sum multiple? So let us start the work. The general definition of a divisor, a factor or sum multiple is a number. It may be a natural number. It may be an integer. But in our lecture, when I will say that an integer, you will have to suppose that is the positive integer. That is the
positive.
And the positive integers are natural numbers. So my first question is, what are natural numbers? What is meant by natural numbers? Counting numbers are called
natural
numbers. So the definition of natural numbers: counting numbers are called
natural
numbers. So these are what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. So these are the numbers that we use for counting the objects, things, etc. in our daily life. Okay?
Yes.
So now, how natural numbers are denoted, or what is the method to represent the natural numbers? So representation of natural numbers. mathematically sometimes it is called symbolically. Natural numbers are denoted by this symbol, capital N and a line here. Natural numbers. Okay? So set of natural numbers, it is denoted by capital N, and its value is 1, 2, 3 and so on. These three dots mean unlimited natural numbers are after this three. Okay? So now, after understanding the concept of natural numbers, we will talk about the definition of a factor. What is meant by a factor? So, what is a factor? A natural number A. And I will write this symbolically, a natural number. This whole statement can be symbolized as this statement. A natural number A is said to be the factor of another natural number B, and it is symbolically written as B belongs to set of
natural
numbers. Okay?
Yes.
A is a number that is natural. B is a number that is also
natural.
And we are going to establish the relationship of factor between A and B. We are saying that A is factor of B. The relation of A with B is the relation of factor. Okay? A natural number A is said to be the factor of another natural number B, if and only if. If and only if. Its symbolical form is this. Okay? And its short form is this, I-double-F. This is the statement number 1. This is the fact number 1. This definition says that the fact number 1 is true or valid when the fact number 2 is valid, or the condition number 2 is valid. So what is the condition number 2? That will be written after this symbol, after this statement. So what is that condition? If and only if B can be written as a natural product or multiple multiple of A. So this English statement means what? And this statement can be symbolized as if and only if B is equal to A multiplied with some natural number n. And I have to define what is this n, where n belongs to set of natural numbers. This is the generalized definition of a factor. Before giving some examples, I have to define some words that are given in the definition. Natural product or multiple. What is meant by these two words in this definition? Now you know the meaning of this word, what is meant by the natural number. I have given you the definition of natural number. What is meant by natural number? Counting numbers are called natural numbers. And the counting starts from 1, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. And the symbolical representation of natural number is given to you on this slide. And now, we will talk about the natural product. So first of all, we have to define this word, what is meant by product or multiple. Okay? So what is meant by product or multiple? Yes, define it. Multiplication is called. So let me explain what is meant by the product. This multiplication is a process, or in mathematical way or in mathematical terms, it is a function. Today I am not going to define the function, but you will have to keep it in mind that this function is a really very beautiful mathematical tool that is used to convert the real world problems into mathematical symbols. Real world processes into mathematical language. It is that tool. So let us define product. The definition of product is the output or result of multiplication of two numbers is called product. And now I will tell you, or I will give you the example. The example is, there is a number A and there is another number B, and you are multiplying these two numbers. And then the result that you will have after this multiplication, that number is called product. That number is called product. For example, 2 multiplied 3 is equal to 6. So this 6 is product. Any confusion? This 6 is product. And this cross shows the process of multiplication is going on between these two numbers. And multiplication is what? And what is the definition of multiplication? In short words or in a nutshell, the definition of multiplication is the short cut way, the shortcut way of writing the repeated addition is called multiplication. I'm not going in the details of this process. If you want to learn the definition of this process in details, then I will give you the definition in some other lecture. Okay? So, the definition of product is clear?
Yes.
Multiplication is not product, it is the process after which you will have a result, and that result is called the product. And these two numbers, 2 and 3, are the multiplicands. These two numbers, 2 and 3, are also called the factors of this 6. And this 6 is also called the multiple of 2 and 3. Okay?
Yes.
You can also say that this 6 is the multiple of 2 with 3. This is the product of 2 with 3. Okay?
Yes.
So this sign is not the product, or this process is not the product. This is multiplication, and this is the process after which you will have the product. Any problem?
No.
Now, I will give you some more examples of product. 9 multiplied 2 is 18. 6 multiplied 10 is 60. Which number is product and which number is factor? Any student? This 9 is product?
No.
This 2 is product?
No.
This 18 is product?
Yes.
So this is the product. And this is the number that you are obtaining after multiplying 9 and 2 with each other. After the process of multiplication, you are obtaining this number 18. Okay?
Yes.
This 6 is not the product. This 10 is not the product. This symbol is product?
No.
No. So this 60 is the product of 6 and 10. Any problem?
No.
So what is 9? 9 is the factor of 18. 18 is the product. But 9 is
factor.
2 is
factor.
Okay? And this is the sign of multiplication, of the process that is going on between these two numbers. Okay?
Yes.
So let us come back to the definition of a factor. So B can be written as a natural product or multiple of A. I have a number 2. Okay? And I am starting the multiplication of this 2 with all natural numbers. All? 2 multiply 1, 2 multiply 2, 2 multiply 3, 2 multiply 4, 2 multiply 5, 2 multiply 6, 2 multiply 7, 2 multiply 8, 2 multiply 9. And so on. 2 multiply 1 is
2.
2 multiply 2 is
4.
6.
8. 10.
12.
14.
Yes, 14.
16.
Yes.
18.
18 and?
So on.
So on. You will have 20, 22, 24, 26, 28. These numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and so on, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 are natural numbers. Okay?
Yes.
And I am multiplying these all natural numbers with a number, that is 2. I am obtaining a product, that is 2, that is 4, that is 6, and these products are obtained by multiplying 2 with some natural number. So this is the natural product, because this is obtained by multiplying the number 2, that is also a natural number, with some other natural number. Okay?
Yes.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18 are the products of 2 with some other natural number. Okay?
Yes.
I can write 3 multiply, set up natural numbers. And this will be equal to what? 3 multiplied with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. So 3 multiply set of natural numbers. 3 multiply 1, result will be 3. 3 multiply 2, 6. 3 3 the
9.
3 4 the 12. And 3 5 the
15.
3 6 the
18.
And so on. So these numbers are the natural products of 3. Okay? You are getting the point or not? What is meant by natural product? First of all, I define the product. So these are the natural products of 2. And these are the natural products of
3.
And similarly, you can write the natural products of 4, 5, 6, and so on. So what is the natural product? The product of a number with some natural number is called as natural product. So let me write down the definition of natural product. The product of a number that is also natural, of a natural number with some natural number is called natural product of a number. Any problem? So this is the definition of natural product, and I have given you the examples of natural products. So if P can be written as a natural product, means what? If your B is 4, your B is 4, and your A is 2, then the value of n is 2. If your B is 10, that is product, that is the natural product. B is product of what? 2, that is A, with some other natural number, that is 5. Okay? Your A is 2, your B is 12, and the natural number that is multiplied with 2 to have 12 as a natural product is 6. Okay?
Yes.
the value of n is 6. Any problem? So after having the definition of natural product, now you are able to define a factor. And I will give you different definitions of a factor, not only one. So let me define factor. A natural number, A, that is symbolically written as this, okay, is said to be the factor of another natural number B, and the symbolical way to write this whole statement is this. If and only if B is product, B is natural product of A. The short way to write the effect after the if and only if statement is B is natural product of A, or B, this equal means is natural product. I will have a natural number and multiplied with this A, and I have to tell that this N is also natural. Okay, you know what is meant by the table of 2, table of 3, table of 4, that is the list of the natural table of 2 or some natural number, or a natural number means what? The table of 2 is the list of all natural products of 2, or the table of a natural number is the list of all natural products of a natural number. The table of 2 is 2 times 1 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 3 is 6. This is the table of 2. But this table is giving you the list of all natural products or all natural multiples of 2. Okay? So the other way to define factor is, what? If B occurs in the table of R, B occurs in the table of A. If B is 6 and A is 3, 6 comes in the table of 3 or not? 3 1 the 3, 3 2 the 6. So this means 6 is the natural product of 3. And we can say that this 3 is the factor of 6. Always remember this statement, that factor is always smaller than the product. It is a fact for you that factor is always smaller than the smaller than or equal or equal to the product, the or multiple. Factor is always smaller than or equal to the product or multiple. What is meant by this statement? I will give you some examples and then you will understand. 2 multiply 5 is equal to 10. This 10 is multiple and 2 is factor. 2 is because 10 is occurring in the table of 2. Or 10 can be written as a product of or a natural product of 2. 10 can be written as a natural multiple of 2. Or 10 can be obtained by multiplying 2 with some other natural number. Okay? 10 can be written as a product of 2. So therefore 2 is the factor of 10. And always remember this point that factor is smaller than or equal to the product or the multiple. Now see here, 2 is the factor and 10 is product or multiple. So what is the relation between 2 and 10? 2 is smaller than 10. I have another example that 2 multiply 1 is what? 2. Here 2 is also a multiple and here this 2 is the factor. Okay, this is the multiple, but here the relation between 2 and 2 is the relation of equality. Okay, so the point that the factor is always smaller than or equal to, not bigger or greater than what? The multiple of the product. The relation between the factor and the multiple is factor is always smaller than the product or multiple. So here you can see that 2 is factor, not the 10 is factor. 10 is product, 10 is multiple. The 2 is factor. You are getting my point or not?
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
Any problem?
No.
So I have given you another equivalent statement that a natural number A is the factor of another natural number B if and only if B is a natural multiple of 2 or if B is a natural multiple of A. A is some number. A is factor of B. A is natural and B is also natural. Number A is the factor of number B. If and only if B is natural product of A. This is the first statement, this is the second statement. If this statement is fulfilled, then this is also fulfilled. If this statement is true, then this statement is also true. I have another statement for you. Or if and only if, the third statement, B occurs in the table of A. A is factor of B if B is in the table of A. If I am asking you that 2 is the factor of 14, then you will check that 14 is occurring in the table of 2. 14 is occurring in the table of 2 or not? If 14 is in the table of 2, then 2 is the factor of 14. And remember the fact that the factor is always smaller than or equal to the product or the multiple. You will have to first of all check that what is the order between A and B. Okay?
Yes.
If A is greater than B, then it is not possible that a greater number is the factor of a smaller number. If you are asking me that 14 is the factor of 2, no, 2 is not occurring in the table of 14. You are getting my point or not?
Yes.
Okay. So, the definition of the factor is a natural number. A is the factor of B. If and only if B is in the table of A. I have a question that 2 is the factor of 8. How you will tell me? How you will check it? If you are going to check that 2 is the factor of 8, then you will have to write a table of 2, not 8. So let me write. So answer is, write down the table of this number 2 that you are going to check, that is this factor or not, table of 2. Okay, so what is that? 2 to the 4, 2 to the 6, 2 to the 4, 8. So yes, this 8 is occurring in the table of 2, so 2 is the factor of 8, and the relation between 2 and 8 is 2 is smaller than 8. This is one of the facts that if you are going to check that this number is the factor of other number, then you will have to first of all ensure that the number that you are going to check is the factor of some other number. First of all, check that that number is smaller than the other number. So here in this example, 2 is smaller than 8. Now then you will have to write the table of 2. If 2 or the first number is not smaller than the other number, then don't check. Then don't check and simply say that this number is not the factor of 8. If you are given this question that 8, is 8 a factor of 2? So what is the answer of this question? No. Why? The steps to check that a number is the factor of some other number are: number one, you will have to check that what is the relationship between this number and this number. If this number that is factor, or you are going to check that this is factor, or the number that may be the factor, you will have to check that is this number is smaller than this number. So 8 is greater than 2. So stop here and write down that 8 is not the factor of 2, because factor is always smaller than or equal to the product of the multiple. So how 8 can be the multiple or product of 2 if 8 is greater than 2? Okay. So the first step to check that a number is factor of the other number, you will have to check the relation or the order between the numbers. If the number that you are going to check that is the factor is smaller than or equal to the other number, then you will have to do the second step. If the number that you are going to check is the factor of other number is greater than the other number, then stop the work and say that no, this number is not the factor. Okay. Another example that is 12 a factor of 6? No?
Yes.
Why? Because 12 is greater than 6. Okay?
Yes.
So steps for checking factor. The first step is to check the relation. Check the relation between A and B. This 12 is A and this 6 is
B.
Okay?
Yes.
If A is greater than B, then stop. Okay?
Yes.
So this means A is not
factor
of B. Why? Because factor is always smaller than or equal to the multiple product. This is the first condition. Okay? After first step. First step will decide that you are going to do the second step or not. Understand? And the second condition, that is A may be equal to B or A may be less than B. If this sort of relation is occurring between A and B, then you will have to perform the second step. Okay? So what is the second step? Write down the table of this smaller number A, or the number that you are going to check, that is the factor or not. Steps are clear?
Yes.
The first step is check that what is the relation between A and B. If A is greater than B, then stop and say that A is not the factor of B, because the fact that factor is always smaller than or equal to the product or multiple. If A is smaller than or equal to B, then you will have to perform the second step. Okay? After performing the second step, if B is not in the table of A. Okay? If B is not in the table of A, then A is not the factor of B. Or we can say that if B cannot be written as a natural product of A, then A is not factor of B. Any problem?
No.
So I have elaborated or explained the definition of a factor. That is, what is meant by the factor? A natural number A is said to be the factor of another natural number B. If and only if B can be written as a natural product of A, or B is in the table of A, or mathematically B can be written as a natural product of A. The fourth equivalent statement is B is A multiply some natural number. This is the mathematical way, or mathematical symbolization of these two statements. These are two English statements, and if you will write these two statements in the mathematical way, then the statement will be the resultant statement, or the result of these two statements. any problem. The symbolical way to write A is the factor of B. No notation for this statement. A is factor of
B.
It is symbolically written as A this bar divides B, or A is the factor of B. A is the factor of
B.
A is the factor of B. Symbolically it is written as this. And if A is not the factor of B, then its symbolical representation is symbolically it is written as A. You will have to cross this. A is not the factor of B, or A does not divide B. A is not the factor of B. A does not divide B. Okay, this means that B is not occurring in the table of A. This statement means B is not in the table or in the natural products of A. B is not in the table of A. Or the table of multiples of A, natural multiples of A. Okay? B is not in the table of A, or B is not in the natural multiples of A. Or you can say that B is not equal to A multiply some natural number. Okay? For this statement, A is the factor of B means what? B is in the table of A. B is a natural multiple of A, or B is A multiply some natural number. Okay, any problem?
No.
Let us do some examples. Now we write the examples in symbolical way. Is 2 factor of 20? Is 2 factor of 20 or not? So first of all, we will have to check what is the relation between 2 and 20. This 2 is smaller than 20. So we will do the other step, that is the second step. So I will write this statement that B is A multiply some natural number. I have to check that this N is natural. Okay? So the value of B is 20, the value of A is 2. So I will write here 20 is equal to 2 multiply N. And how we will find out the value of this n? Divide both sides with 2. This 2 is cancelled with this 2. 2 1 the 2, 2 10 the. So the value of n is
10.
Is this 10 a natural number or not? So since 10, that is n, is natural number, this implies that 2 divides 20. This means 2 is factor of 20. Or 2 is some multiple of 20. Any problem? No, let us do another example. Is 3 a factor of 15? So the solution is 3 smaller than 15. We will check that 15 can be written as a natural product of 3. So 3 multiplies some natural number. We will divide both sides with 3. We will have 5. The value of n is 5. So because 5, which is n, is a natural. 5 is in the set of natural numbers. So this implies that 3 is factor of 15. Any problem? Now, how we can say that 3 divides 15. Another example is 5 a factor of 12? So what is the way to check? 5 is smaller than 12. So now we will check that 12 is occurring in the table of 5. 12 is equal to 5 multiply n. So dividing both sides with 5. We will divide both sides with 5. The 5 is cancelled with this 5. So you can divide this 12 by 5. 12 is not occurring in the table of 5. So this implies that the value of n is 12 by 5. Natural numbers are 1, 2, 3 and so on. This number is not occurring in the natural number. So therefore this is not a natural number. So we can say that an n is not a natural number. We cannot write this 12 as a product of 5, as a natural product of 5. So this implies that 5 is not the factor of 12, or 5 is not factor of 12. I will give you another example. 12 is factor of 6. Solution. First of all, check that 12 is smaller than 6 or greater than 6. So say that 12 is not factor of 6, because a factor is always smaller than or equal to the multiple of the product. So therefore the first test is failed. So there is no need to perform the second test. Okay?
Yes.
There are two tests to check a number is the factor of some other number. The first test is this, that you will have to check that the first number is smaller than the other number, the first number is equal to the other number, or the first number is greater than the other number. So if the first number is smaller than or equal to the other number, the second number, then you will have to perform the second test, or you have to write on the table, or you have to find out the natural number that is the number when it is multiplied with the given natural number, it will give you the B. We can say here that number is 6. So we cannot write this 6 as a natural product of 12. So we will write here that 12 does not divide 6, or 12 is not the factor of 6. Any problem? And the reason is this, that 12 is greater than 6. But this sort of relation is not existing between the factor and the multiple or the product. Any problem? So now, after understanding the definition of a factor and understanding the examples, the summary of this whole topic is this. If you are checking that a natural number A is the factor of some other natural number B, A is some number, B is some number, that will be taken from the set of natural numbers. The value of A, the value of B is from this set. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. A will be from this set and B will be from this set. Any number. Okay?
Yes.
A may be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. B may be some number from the set of natural numbers. When you are going to check that A is the factor of B, first number is the factor of second number, you will have to write in a table of first number. If you are going to check that A is the factor of B, A divides B, then you will have to write on a table of this number. Okay? Write the table of this A. If B is occurring in the table of A, then you will say that A is the factor of B. Because you are writing the table of A. So you are going to check that A is the factor of B. B will be the multiple or the natural multiple of A. Any problem? Everything is clear to you?
Yes.
So now, when you have understood the idea of factor, now you are able to understand the idea of a prime number and a composite number. What is a prime number and what is a composite number? First of all, I have explained you the definition of a factor. Now, there is another question. How you can write all factors of a number? Now you can check that a number A is the factor of B or not. After taking this lecture, we are able how to check that A is factor of B or not. But there is another question. How to write all factors of B, a given number, a natural number. If you are given the question that write down all factors of 18, how you will write? You are able to check that 2 is the factor of 18 or not. Two tests. First of all, you will have to check the relationship between 2 and 18. Okay? Because 2 is smaller than 18, then you will have to write on the table of 2. If 18 is occurring in the table of 2, you will say that 2 is the factor of 18. But how you will answer the second question? If you are given the task that write down all factors of
18.
So how you will write? What is the way to write all factors of 18 or a number B? B may be 20, B may be 30, B may be 25, B may be 23. Any natural number. Okay? Okay? B is some natural number. It is not always 18. It may be 30. It may be 100. It may be 1 lakh. It may be 55. Okay? So when you are given a natural number and the question is, write down all factors of this number. What is the way to write down the factors of it? Of a given natural number. Okay? I will give you the answer of this second question in my next lecture. Okay? The answer of this question will be given to you in my next lecture. Today we will stop here, and if you want to learn more from me, then you will have to listen my second lecture. And after giving the second lecture, I will define composite numbers and prime numbers in my third lecture. Okay? So thank you very much for listening to me. Allah Hafiz.